Welcome back to the Gentleman's Gazette. In today's video, we'll be sharing some of our favorite double-edged razor blades with you and helping you to figure out what your ideal blade should be. A fine shave is one of the best ways to mentally prepare yourself for anything the day might throw at you, and in our opinion, wet shaving with a double-edged safety razor should provide you with the best quality shave in most cases. And what's essential for the best possible double-edged razor shave? The best possible double-edged blade, of course. So, today's video will discuss how to identify a quality DE blade, review several prominent brands, and share some of our own personal experiences. What we won't be doing today is explaining how to use a double-edged razor or its blades, as Raphael has already covered that subject in this video. Before we start, though, keep in mind that shaving is a highly subjective experience, and this video can only go over what makes a great blade generally. Meanwhile, whatever will be the best blade for you personally is going to vary based upon a number of factors, including your own shaving routine, hair type, and skin sensitivity. Fortunately, though, DE shaving is one of the most economical ways to shave, which is just one of the reasons why we believe it has electric and cartridge razor shaving beat. And it's economical chiefly because DE blades are very inexpensive. Phrased another way, you could basically test every blade that we'll mention in today's video for around the cost of a nice lunch. Conversely, if you had to purchase every pair of shoes we mentioned in our recent ready-to-wear shoe ranking video, you might have to mortgage your house. Speaking of which, we haven't set today's video up as a ranking purely because the shaving experience is so subjective from person to person. Still, we will be going into a good deal of detail on each of the blades we discuss. Let's begin today, though, by briefly going over some of the general characteristics you should look for in a quality double-edged blade. One major plus to most double-edged blades, regardless of their actual shaving quality, is price. As we already mentioned, price is a very attractive aspect of DE shaving, as you can simply divide the total cost of a pack of blades by the number of blades in the pack to get the cost per blade. Furthermore, an even more useful figure here can be the cost per shave. Remember, most quality DE blades can be used two times at least, and sometimes even more. So, for instance, if a $10 pack of blades has 100 blades in it, then the cost per blade is 10 cents. But if each blade can be used twice, then the cost per shave is just 5 cents. This ability to reuse blades is discussed under the term durability. Blades with good durability will see a minimal drop in functionality over subsequent shaves, but of course, even high-quality blades will eventually dull with repeated use. And again, how often you need to change blades will also come down to your shaving routine, hair type, and skin type. After all, if you have fine, thin facial hair, you may only need to shave every couple of days, whereas some men with especially thick hair might even be shaving twice a day. That, of course, is assuming you want to remain clean-shaven and not just grow a beard or other facial hairstyles, and for more information on beards, you can consult our grooming playlist here. In any case, most quality double-edged blades should be able to be used two or three times, with some men even being able to use the same blade up to seven or eight times. But of course, for the best possible shave, using a new blade each time you shave can't be beat. Blades are usually made from carbon steel or stainless steel, then coated with nitride and another metal. This is often platinum, tungsten, or chromium. Platinum improves durability by helping to keep the blade sharp, tungsten improves durability by reducing corrosion, and chromium improves sharpness for a smoother, closer shave. So, the coding that's right for you will depend on what you like to see and prefer most in your own shaving experience. Next, considerable emphasis is sometimes placed on where a razor blade is manufactured. The assumption here is that some countries are just better at this trade than others, able to more consistently produce high-quality DE blades. In our experience, brand reputation is more important overall than country of manufacture. Phrased another way, quality blades can come from anywhere. That being said, country of origin can indicate standards when it comes to things like labor practices, environmental regulation, or quality assurances. So, knowing where your blades came from can't hurt. And speaking of consistency, because razor blades are a mass-produced product with hundreds of blades in one box, statistically, you are bound to just get a dud every once in a while. But high-quality brands should be able to more consistently produce high-quality blades with fewer duds. Next, we've mentioned multiple times that shaving will depend on your own routine, hair, and skin, so let's get into a few more details there. The performance of your blade will first vary based upon your hair type, because, as you might imagine, a coarser hair is simply tougher to cut through than a fine hair is. Hair length will also be a factor, as longer hairs are more difficult to cut than shorter ones. Skin type is also a factor, especially if your skin is rough, sensitive, or prone to acne. Your hair, and especially your skin, will also be impacted by how frequently you're shaving, as more shaves throughout the week could put more stress on your skin. And finally here, we'll touch on skill level, which is to say just how comfortable you are wielding a double-edged razor and its blades. All of these realities, then, will affect the experience you have with a given blade, especially as it relates to that blade's sharpness. In the DE shaving community, you're often going to hear sharper blades referred to as aggressive, and less sharp blades referred to as mild or forgiving. A good sharp blade is essential for a close shave, but sharper is not always better. If you have fine, thin hair, for instance, you won't necessarily need an extremely sharp blade to get a close shave, and that sharpness may cause undue irritation if you have sensitive skin. Conversely, if you have coarse, thick, or long hair, anything other than a very sharp blade could leave you with an incomplete shave and more irritation, as it's going to pull and tug at your hairs and stubble. Appropriate sharpness can also be related to skill level, as if you're just starting out in the world of DE shaving, the sharpest blades might be more likely to nick and cut you. So, even if you do have coarse hair and average skin, you may want to steer clear of the sharpest blades on the market for at least a little while when you're just starting out, until you build up some more experience. And even if you're a very accomplished shaver, if you have exceptionally sensitive skin, you may also want to steer clear of the sharpest possible blades and go for something a bit milder. To summarize all of these points here, I'll share my own personal experiences. I have sensitive skin and relatively coarse facial hair. The coverage isn't dense, but each individual hair is thick. When I was new to DE shaving, I was apprehensive about using the sharpest blades, as I was afraid they would be more likely to nick and cut me, so I stuck with a more medium-sharp blade. However, I still suffered some irritation, mostly on my neck area. As I got more comfortable DE shaving over time, and as I switched to a razor head with a thinner blade gap, I decided to try an even sharper blade, and this has resulted in less irritation for me overall. Why is this? Well, again, when a sharper blade is used properly, it means fewer passes over the skin, which means less irritation. All of this just goes to show that what will ultimately matter most is the shaving experience that works for you. Now, with all of that discussed, we'll share our experiences with some of the most popular razor blades on the market today. We'll go over all of these brands in alphabetical order, and we'll cut to the chase by saying that this video is definitely not sponsored. The information in this video was sourced in part from prior blade tests that we've done as part of our comprehensive shaving guide, which you can find in ebook form in the Fort Belvedere shop here. We also sourced opinions from our followers on social media. So if you'd like to add to the discussion in future videos, make sure that you're following us on our social channels. And finally, we conducted a new round of testing for 8 different blade brands. As you'll see, my beard was longer than usual, and I didn't knock it down to stubble first using an electric shaver as I normally would, as we wanted to see how these blades would handle a significant challenge. With all that said then, let's jump into our conclusions. The first blade brand we'll discuss today is Astra, which is made predominantly in Russia and owned today by Procter & Gamble. By the way, P&G also owns Gillette. Astra offers several blades with various coatings, and they're generally known for providing good all-around blades that balance sharpness with still being forgiving. They're suitable for men with sensitive skin, and perhaps that's why they were preferred by so many of you in our poll. I learned how to shave using Astra blades, specifically their Green Superior Platinum line, and Astra blades are still used by Jack, one of our scriptwriters and our social media manager. In my experience, they provide a close, consistent shave and can be used 2 or even 3 times. However, since they're not quite as sharp as some other blades, they do require more passes on my relatively coarse hair, resulting in a bit more irritation overall. They're not my first choice at this point in time, stay tuned to find out what is, but I will say that they comfortably occupy my number 2 or backup spot. Next, Bic may be most well known for their disposable pens and disposable cartridge razors, but they make a surprisingly good DE razor blade too. In particular, we'll mention their Chrome Platinum series, which is made in Greece. These blades are sharp, but also forgiving, so if you have coarse or long hair and are still new to DE shaving, they could be a good starter model. Bluebird can prove to be a bluebird of happiness for skilled shavers who need an especially sharp blade. But these scalpel-sharp Turkish blades are very unforgiving, so we wouldn't recommend them to new shavers. Depending on your hair texture and shaving regimen, though, that sharpness can translate to more closeness and fewer passes, resulting in greater durability and a lower cost per shave. Next is Darby, also a Turkish company, with most of their blades being made in Sweden. Their DE blades generally go by Darby Extra, and we've found that they're a good choice for shavers with sensitive skin or beginners with any hair type. The one exception to this, though, is if you have especially coarse hair. In that case, Darby blades might not work very well for you. To that point, I've tried Darby blades before, and while their performance was decent overall, I found that they had a tough time with my relatively coarse hair. Overall, this led to some tugging and pulling, and ultimately a bit of irritation resulted. Next up is Feather, a name well known in the wet shaving community for being almost synonymous with sharpness. Their blades are so notoriously sharp that they could probably cut a feather in half. Comment below if you recognize this classic of early German cinema. Made in Japan, Feather blades are renowned for their sharpness and aggressiveness, making them ideal for men with thick and coarse hair. Along with this sharpness, they also sport fantastic durability. Conventional wisdom is that feather blades are too aggressive for men with sensitive or irregular skin, and overkill for men with fine hair. As I've become more comfortable and seasoned with DE shaving, though, I have switched to feathers, and I've found that they now give me less irritation in my shaving routine. The extra sharpness means fewer passes, and fewer passes means less irritation. Plus, as mentioned, I have relatively coarse hair, and the feather blades cut through it with ease. So, just like Raphael, feather blades are now also my go-to choice. Gillette is another juggernaut in the shaving world, and the flagship of the Procter & Gamble company. Most of its blades are made in either India or Russia, and it sports a number of different sub-brands and lines of blades, all with different coatings and finishes. In our prior testing, we found these blades to be good all-around options, especially for men with average skin and hair. Gillette blades are easy to find and relatively cheap, and while they aren't as durable as some other brands, they provide a decent quality shave with decent closeness. In other words, decent is really the operative word here. The Lord brand hails from Egypt, and in addition to being another good choice for men with average hair and skin sensitivity, it's also a brand known to be especially consistent in its manufacturing quality. Lord blades are comfortable and forgiving, so while they might not work well for men with especially coarse hair or sensitive skin, they should work well for pretty much everyone else. Next, Merkur is said to offer the great return on investment that any German brand should offer. Did Raphael write this? Known primarily for their razor bodies, commenters have found Merkur blades to be sharp, thick, and durable. But in our own testing, I found them to be unsuitable for my coarse hair. I experienced quite a bit of tugging and pulling, with the blade catching my hair and pulling my skin before actually doing much cutting. The blades also had an odd brown color to them, which may have been the result of defective manufacturing. As the package noted, rather than being made in Germany, they were manufactured in the Czech Republic. I learned how to DE shave with a Merkur razor, but I don't personally feel nearly as positively about their blades. Another blade that proved very popular in our polls was Müller, manufactured in Germany. Genuinely this time, we think. Müller is known for versatility, ease of use, and forgiving but sharp blades. Again though, I didn't happen to have great personal experience here. These blades weren't quite as bad as the Merkur models, but I did still experience some tugging and pulling while shaving. With that said though, these blades might be a good option for shavers with finer hair. I have a Müller razor in my collection, and I use its handle along with a razor head from Henson Shaving most of the time, but their blades aren't for me. Your mileage may vary though. Next, hailing from Sweden, blades from Parker feature each of the standard coatings, chromium, platinum, and tungsten. They allow for smooth, close, and comfortable shaves that will work well for most skin types. And they should be able to handle most hair types as well. Many of their lines also come in individual plastic cases for easy traveling. We accidentally ordered half blades for the video, which are used in some razor and shavette models, but they're manufactured to the same standard as the regular DE blades. Parker even refers to them on their website as pre-cut blades, as many men simply take regular DE blades and snap them in half for use in some particular razor types. But we pressed ahead with our testing, inserting one of these half blades into my DE razor. Here, by the way, is your don't try this at home warning. And don't let it be said that I don't put myself on the line for our viewers. Despite the less than ideal setup, though, these blades actually performed quite well for me. I experienced no tugging and pulling, and no irritation while shaving. I did find that the shave was less close or precise than it was with some other models, but again, this may have just been down to our particular setup, so your mileage may vary here. Made in the USA, Persona blades boast feather-level sharpness at a reduced price, but they also have a lower overall durability. Still, if you have finer hair, you could get a good bang for your buck with these blades. For a coarse-haired shaver like me, though, these blades were unfortunately persona non grata.
Ooh, you suck!
I found these blades to leave more hair behind than Feather, Astra, or Parker did, and while they didn't pull or tug as much as some of the other models, they did still leave a bit of irritation afterward. These were better than Mercure and Mühle for me, and on par with Darby overall. Next, Shark blades have the benefit of being extremely forgiving, despite what their name might suggest. So, while they might not be great options for men with thick, coarse, or long hair, they could be a good choice for shavers with sensitive skin or beginners to DE shaving. They're also very economical, benefiting from lower labor costs in their country of origin, Egypt. In our prior round of blade testing for the shaving guide, though, we did have some problems with the Shark blades we received when it came to their consistency from blade to blade. This wasn't a problem large enough to ruin our shaving experience with Shark blades, but it's still something to be mindful of. Voskhod is a Russian company that produces a good all-around blade. It has good durability and sharpness, and is neither aggressive nor overly mild. Some find that these blades, which are made from stainless steel, can be more irritating on the skin, but a light touch and reduced pressure can ameliorate this. And to reduce irritation to sensitive skin, you could, of course, simply cycle through your blades more quickly. I was pleasantly surprised overall by Voskhod blades in our recent testing. They were generally sharp and precise, with just a bit of irritation. I would put them in the middle of the pack for my own personal experience, below Feather, Astra, and Parker, and above Persona, Darby, Mühle, and Mercure. Finally today, we'll mention Wilkinson's Sword, whose classic line is made in Germany. And while they're not as sharp as the sabers on the package, or indeed the notoriously sharp Feather, they do still have a good ratio of sharpness to durability. This should result in a close shave with the same blade multiple times, leading to a good overall cost per blade. This durability can perhaps be attributed at least in part to the proprietary triple coating on each of the blades. And again, this blade should be suitable for most shavers, unless you have particularly sensitive skin or coarse hair. With all of this said then, does it seem like you have too many blade options to choose from? Well, never fear, as sampler sets are here. Samplers will allow you to try small selections of multiple blades within the same overall package to test out multiple models and find what works best for you personally. You can find razor sampler packs online, and many brick and mortar shaving emporia will also assemble their own sampler packs, with things like a beginner's pack for ease of use or an aggressive pack featuring just the sharpest blades. Now that we've run through over a dozen blade brands then, what are our recommendations? First, we don't think you can go wrong with Feather, which is a favorite of the notoriously coarse-haired Raphael, now my own go-to, and also a favorite of many of you who commented for this video. Bluebird can be another great option if you want something that's not quite as sharp as a Feather, and Bic might be a good option if you have coarse hair and are a beginner. Per my own testing, Parker was also a strong contender, and you might want to give Voskhod a shot too. Meanwhile, if sensitive skin is your primary concern, then Astra is hard to beat for a close shave that shouldn't be too irritating. But if you want to be extra careful, Shark can be a good option, if you don't have coarse hair, and if you've got some more experience under your belt, you might also want to try Wilkinson's Sword here. When it comes to the best value, we'll say that any blade that gives you a shave that you like should represent the best value to you. After all, a good quality shave with minimal nicks should be priceless. That being said, Astra and Bluebird both offer high quality shaves at relatively low prices per our own testing. When it comes to the closest shave, for us here at GG, Feather is an obvious contender, as is Astra. But ultimately, closeness ends up being such a product of personal preference, especially when it comes to your skin and hair type, that your results could vary greatly here. If you're just starting out on your DE shaving journey, then Darby and Shark are going to be good options that should give you a quality shave with minimal nicks and cuts. But if you're already comfortable with the idea of shaving and prefer something sharper even as a beginner, then we would recommend Astra. Once you feel like you've mastered the art of DE shaving, you might feel naturally inclined to graduate to the Feather blade. That certainly has been Raphael's experience and mine, but for men with especially sensitive skin, something like Wilkinson's Sword might be a better choice. And finally here, while Mercur, Mula, and Persona didn't work well for me personally in our testing, remember that that doesn't necessarily mean your experience will be the same. Remember that DE shaving is going to provide unique results for everyone who tries it, and that's all part of the experience and the enjoyment. So, now that we've explained what makes a great razor blade, we hope that you'll feel empowered to get shaving to see what works best for you. To everyone who contributed their own insight and opinions to this video, we thank you for making it a cut above. And if you didn't get the chance to contribute, or you feel that there are other brands we missed and should cover in the future, then let us know in the comments below. In today's video, I'm wearing a casual outfit, good for sitting around the house and maybe practicing my DE shaving. It consists chiefly of a plain black polo shirt and medium gray trousers, which have a bit of texture and pattern in their weave that I thought was vaguely reminiscent of the knurling on a traditional DE razor handle. I've worn my silver wedding band today to go along with the color feel, and while I've left product out of my hair, I am, of course, freshly shaved with a Feather blade, by the way. My belt in black leather and silver metal also harmonizes with the other elements of my outfit while remaining understated. My loafers are well-loved plain black models from Allen Edmonds, and rounding out my outfit today are two selections from the Fort Belvedere shop. First are my two-toned solid socks in black and white, again harmonizing with the color feel of the outfit, and for a fragrance, I've gone with Darby from the Roberto Ugolini collection. In addition to enjoying its well-rounded scent, I also picked it because it has a name in common with one of the blade brands we tested today, and because the black bottle harmonizes with my outfit too. For the socks I'm wearing in today's video, a wide array of other classic men's accessories, and this and other scents from the Roberto Ugolini collection, you can take a look at the Fort Belvedere shop here. We'll be right back.